Hey, welcome back, class. So looking at number four, you're given the front, top, and right view, and then you're asked to draw an isometric view of the part. Okay, it should be proportional to what you see in your multi-view. So let me document what I see here. This is the front view. This is the top. And this is the right. Now, I want you to notice a couple of things about this. This is important. This front view, if you look at the boxes, this is one unit, two, three, four, five, six, seven units. Alrighty. And so now, when you look at that front view, when you draw your isometric drawing, again, you're using these grids that are angled. I believe they're, they might be 60 degree triangles, equal angular triangles that create these polygons. But anyway, what you're doing is you're drawing along this. Let me thicken this up just a hair. You're drawing along this path here, see that? You see that? And that's six units. Now, or seven. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, seven. So you could see it here. There were, probably changed this color. There's a dot. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven units. Okay. And then, of course, taking a look at, let's go blue here. And taking a look here, you see that you're moving upward here. Total of, what is it, six units? Is that right? One, two, three, four, five units. So what you're doing here is moving up five units. There it is, your five units. One, two, three, four, five. You see what's going on? And so you're modeling this front view, coming across two here. Two units there. And so you're doing the same here. Two units. See that? One, two, right? And then you're coming down. One, two, three. One, two, three. See it? And you're coming across. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Starting to see it? And then you move down. One, two. And here down, one, two. Now these are a little thick. I didn't want these to be that thick. Yeah, let's see if I can change this. And so that's the front view. You see what's going on there? See how that works? Now here's where things get tricky. When you start drawing the right view and the top view, you kind of have to visualize what's going on. So, and it's a challenge. You can kind of see here. See if I can get the highlighter. I think this is the highlighter. Yeah, that's dots. I don't want that. See, it's this one here. I wonder why that's dots. That's weird. Yeah, solid. Here we go. Let's go here. Okay. There we go. So when you start looking at this kind of region right in here, that top portion on the right, that represents this here. So this area is notched. You see that? And you can tell that your top view here, you see this open space? That's what this is right here. See that? So now you have to kind of interpret that information and combine it three-dimensionally to create this object that you see here. Okay. Now I've given you the answers. I've kind of poked at this a little bit by highlighting the front view and drawing it in colors and trying to give you an idea of what I'm thinking about when I draw it, right? Using my mind's eye. But, you know, try to do this on your own without looking at the answer. See if it makes sense. Okay. So, good luck with that, okay? Now, question number five, you're asked to take a three-dimensional model that's already given. Let's get this out of the way here. I'm not able to move that. It's weird. But you take the arc here, and you want to draw a multi-view orthographic projection of this model. And you do the best you can to make it somewhat realistic. Okay. And so that's what I did here. Alrighty. So I drew that out. You've got the front view. You've got the right view and the top view. And so utilize that and make sense of it. Okay, there's some hidden lines there that represent these corners here at the bottom that start the arc, right? Here, this top half here, on the right side, that represents that edge created by this arc. And so we added a center line across the top. You've got the center mark here for half of this arc. If you had the whole arc, it would be a circle, right? It would be something like this, right? So that center line would probably make more sense, right? But yeah, you're not drawing the whole circle. It's just an arc portion of the circle. So have fun with this. Make sense of it. And you'll have to turn this in today, okay? So like I always say, study hard. Learn a lot. And we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.